This is the second video on Windows. Here we will learn what are the requirements in terms of free software and meteorological data formats for preparing a Windows. As we know that Windows depicts the frequency of occurrence of winds in each of the specified wind direction sectors and wind speed classes for a given location and time period. For preparation of Windows, we use WRPlotView software, which is freely available and it can be downloaded from Lex software. WRPlotView is a fully operational Windows program for your meteorological data. It provides visual Windows plots, frequency analysis, and plots for several meteorological data formats. To download this software, type WRPlots in Google and hit the first option and then hit on download, appeared on the right side of the screen. After downloaded, you install it and then go to this section that is registration and activation and give your contact information and submit. Once you have submitted your contact information above, an activated code will be sent to your email within 24 hours. Then activate the software and use it for free. I have already done this process and I am going to open this software. So the software appears. At first, we need a Excel file. So just from this tool option, go to import Excel, and from here, before we going to import it, we just want to know what are the requirements in our Excel data. So actually it's only you need a year column, Excel column would have obviously have an year, then month, then day, and then hour, and this is 24 hours. Then we need a wind direction that is in degree, and then wind speed. So you can change it here from a meter per second to kilometer per hour or knots, anything. If and then hourly precipitation, and the hour option is 1 to 24 or 00 to 23 option. So at first we need an Excel file containing wind direction and wind speed data, hourly data of at least a month for preparation of Windows in WRPlotView software. However, the precipitation is hourly precipitation is optional, but we can use it. So seven different field is required, seven different data. So now I going to open a Excel file. This is my Excel file, which contains hourly meteorological data of September 2023 of Siliguri, West Bengal, and it is hour is from 1 to 24 for each day, for day 1 and for day 2, likewise up to day 30. The unit of wind direction is degree, and wind speed is kilometer per hour, and precipitation is in millimeter. Now I'm going to import this file in on my WR plot view. So this is my WR plot view. So I'm going to import this file and select this file. So it appears here. So I have to assign the column in Excel with and to know the software that year is in column A, month B, day C, and hour is SD, and it is in this unit 1 to 24, and wind direction is in degrees, so it is E. Wind speed is in column F, but the unit is kilometer per hour, and precipitation is in Excel column G, and its unit is millimeter. So it's okay, this part. Now I have to set the import first row from row number 3. So if it is the last row is 720 22, it's okay. Now this page is done, data fields. Now I go to the station information. Station ID, I just put a number. CTS give Siliguri, state West Bengal. The latitude is 26.7352 north, and longitude is 88.4088 east. Time zone is 5:30, but 5:30 is not here, so I put it as 5 plus 5. Means level is optional, but I put it 125, and all set here. The output file, I have to give a name of the output file, so it's already there. If you want to change the location, and go to this option, file save as, and do it, and then click import. So it's done. Now you may open this file here if you want that, what is your output file looks like. Oh, sorry. Well, so I close it and close this also. Now I click here the add file and add the new file of .sam just created, and now you can go, can see the meteorological information here. It is done from our previous job. Now you can see the frequency count, frequency distribution, windrows here, and also the graph, wind class frequency distribution graph. And windrows, you can see that the wind blow from north to maximum time, and you, this direction of blowing from, you can change from flow vector to blowing to, then it looks like this. So I prefer this because we have to know that from where wind actually go and hit. So you can see it, but you know, conventionally windrows is from blowing from. So you can change color from here this option, and you can export this Windows to on Google Earth. So before exporting, you just want check the latitude longitude is right or not. Oh yes, it is wrong, so I have to put it again. North, and this is okay. And just click export. You will find that the Windows is appear on the location of the from where the meteorological data was collected. So thank you for watching this video and your patience.